And so today, I am going to be playing some sublists. My next tournament is SCG Richmond, which is in 3 weeks from now, so I have a couple weeks off to kind of just clown around on stream. Don't really need to do any testing on stream, so I can kind of catch up on sublists, play some stuff that's fun, play some stuff I enjoy, and Blue Eye Control definitely squarely fits in that. I am a big Colonnade fan. Love me some Celestial Colonnade. Got a lot of love. Got some foils that have sat in a box for many moons, but unfortunately, it is productive for my win rate to leave my Celestial Colonnades in my deck boxes typically, but there is a couple new things about Blue Eye Control that I do believe have breathed new life into Blue Eye Control, mainly Force of Negation. This is the big one for me. Force of Negation is a card in Blue Eye Control that makes your hands look a little more keepable. Like, you used to be able to look at Blue Eye Control's opening sevens and be like, none of these spells look like their modern power level. Like, what am I doing? My first play is on turn three or turn two and it's a counter spell. Like, miss me. But Force of Negation being able to be card disadvantage at the cost of being essentially free means that you have earlier plays that matter and impact. Hey, Reggie, thanks very much for the host. I appreciate it. I don't even know if it's an auto-host, but I appreciate your host. And Blue Eye Control actually has a lot of cheap forms of card advantage now, mainly the form of Snapcaster Mage, you know, Narset. Even Teferi is a form of card advantage. So you have access to these card advantage engines that are like 2-3 mana in Blue Eye Control now that lets you recoup the card disadvantage from Force Negation. Plus, Force Negation is just like a very reasonable rate to hard cast. So I've liked it a lot. Is it Phoenix? I do think it is main deckable Blue Eye Control. I'm excited to give that a shot. I almost wish you were playing more. I wrote an article a long time ago, I guess it's like only a month this time, that people should be playing more Force Negations in their deck. And I believe that's true for this deck too. I kind of want to find room for a third one somewhere. I don't really know where. I'm pretty flexible. Play McCree. Overwatch. This is an Overwatch stream now. Chat's going to be all Overwatch. I'm not willing to leave it up to, yeah, you got me, I guess. I mean, whatever. It's just not, like, IQs, they make a big difference, especially if you win the points, but, like, I think that the mentality of it is not. I was talking before the stream that I'm not going to be playing any IQs during this off period. Sorry to tangent on you here, those of you on YouTube. But I do have 2 weeks off. I'm not really planning on it. If I might play max one IQ because they're 5 hours plus away, but I don't even think I'm going to play one. And if I miss the Players' Championship because of it, then it'd be like that. I don't think it's worth sacrificing my mental health. And I'm not even sure that it's necessarily going to be better for me. Like, look at Harlan Fearer, somebody that has skipped multiple opens because he just wasn't feeling it and he wanted to, like, if he wasn't enjoying Magic, he didn't want to play. He has 6 open top eights this season, so there's a little Nova plug, you know. I'm sorry, this year, not this season. And so he's just on a heater. He's in contention for the Players Championship, and he's skipping opens, much less going to IQs. So I don't place as much stock on the you have to go to IQs. Moppy Herb 80, thank you very much for the follow. I really appreciate it. Anyways, good thing on Blue Eye Control. Main deck Surgical is necessary for the Hogak metagame. I'm not really sure how our deck is going to fare in the Hogak metagame, but we do have access to Rest in Peace out of the board, which is a big one. You can see we're playing 4 of that card. Otherwise, the deck hasn't really changed in a long time. There's like a Prismatic Vista that I got from Modern Horizons. You got Snow-Covered Lands to kind of bluff on Thin Ice, which I think is a card that maybe fits in your sideboard, but I don't really think there's any other reason to play Snow Cover basics in this deck other than they look cute. 4 Field of Ruins, not really sure how often it's going to be good enough against Tron, but I guess that's mostly a concession to Tron and like creature lands and a flip search for Ezcantif. You know, you run into that, just kind of problematic lands that you run to in the format. 3 Colonnades is a win condition. I think that's actually might be too many. Playing a tap land in the modern format's not really where you want to be, but hey, you know what, I'm here for it. Oust still kind of sucks. Like I said, I wouldn't mind playing an On Thin Ice here because we have, like, you know, Snow-Covered Plains and we have Prismatic Vista, but meh, it's probably super marginal. Pass Ops all makes sense. Spell Snare seems like a fine card, though I'm not sure how good it is. 4 Snapcaster Mage makes a lot of sense. Cheap card advantage. Mana Leak as a one of seems calculated, but who am I to judge? Vendilion Clique's nice synergy with the 3 Narset, so I really like seeing Clique's in this deck list. Timely Reinforcements in the main deck. Seems good against the Moderate Phoenix deck that's rolling around. Excited about Force Negation. Detention Sphere is a good catch-all. Something I don't mind having access to. I wish Council's Judgment was in the format, but pretty excited about that. I don't think think Teferi is actually very good in this deck. We're playing two Teferi Time Raveler, but that's a card I kind of have my eye on as like, hey, I'm not actually sure if this is where I want to be in the format. It just doesn't seem as good as some of the other options. Take like Jace, Narset, you know, all these decks. Like, I'm not sure that Teferi could necessarily just be like a fourth Narset or a third Jace. You know, like, I'm not really sure how impactful this card is, but it does impact the board, so that is a big upside to it, and we'll see how much that comes up as mattering. Also, Instant Speed Verdicts, really nice. Lets you hold up Verdict and Cryptic Command on 4 if you play Teferi, you know, on 3. So, that's kind of a neat little thing. Not sure, once again, not sure how relevant that is, but it is cute. 3 Cryptics, not sure if that's too many Cryptics. Kind of feels like it might be, but excited to play with the card nonetheless. Jace the Mind Sculptor, most busted Planeswalker in Magic, hasn't changed, won't change anytime soon. 1 Teferi is a catch-all, just like another good card advantage Planeswalker that answers problematic permanents that you can't necessarily answer with creature removal, and another Logic Knot. So, main deck makes a lot of sense, sideboard makes a lot of sense, Celestial Purge really good, there's a lot of red cards going around right now, and black cards in Hogak. I'm not sure if you bring this in, but there's a sideboard guy that the particular sub that submitted this list included, so we're just going to follow that as close as possible. 4 Recipes, Hogak's broken. Another sweeper for the creature decks, Baneslayer Angel. I don't know, nice life gain. Also good against the creature decks. Another win condition as well. Wins a little bit faster than this deck normally does. So kind of worried about this going a long time. Mentor for the mirror. And once again, other combo decks where you need to kill them quickly. Stony Silence for mostly the Urza deck, I imagine, but also very good against Tron. Timely Reinforcements, Burn, and the Moderate Phoenix deck, I suppose. Dovin's Veto for problematic non-creature permanents. And Disdainful Stroke. Once again, likely Tron, Eldrazi Tron, hate. So, deck seems relatively well constructed. Excited to play it. Let's jam some games. Blurp. Oh no, 10 decks. Fine. I accept. Reminds me, I actually need to pull up the sideboard guide. Boop. Shout out to Shadows. I think Shadows is in the chat. Subscriber submitted this deck list. I don't know where they got Harry MTG's where they got this deck list and cyborg guide from. Looks pretty sweet. Am I gonna work on this list on stream? I don't know. I'm gonna try what we have here first. I don't really want to go making changes without playing no games with it, the flea. Yeah, this is Overwatch stream. Blurp. Does Mentor come in post-board games, or does it come in most post-board games, only in certain matchups? Ace, I imagine it only comes in, I mean, we can check the sideboard guide, but I imagine it, like, just thinking about how this deck used to play Geist of St. Traft, it mostly comes in against, like, big mana where you need to kill them quickly, combo where you want to kill them quickly, and, like, the mirror where just, like, having another, like, creature threat where, like, you're incentivized to board out all your creature removal, like, where that is, like, a sub-game that you play is, like, how much creature removal do you leave in for the random Snapcaster Mage, like, Monastery Mentor beatdown plans. But, like, you're not going to bring it in. I don't think you're going to bring him in against, like, I don't know. Like, pick a deck. Like, Phoenix? I don't think I want him against Phoenix. Not even really sure I want him against Hogak. You know, just, like, anything. I guess Hogak you probably do. Like, it goes wide and blocks. You know, this is the exact same problem. Like, I want him all again to Force of Negation, but I feel like this hand has to be capable. Yeah, well, let's just play on your turn. Go. Gonna have to play a little bit. Probably a little bit faster than I normally play. I normally like to take a lot of time and talk and think about like what I'm doing. Oh god, please don't be a mirror. The control mirrors used to be a lot of fun in Modern. I don't think they are anymore with the presence of this card. Narset being able to just shut down all the card advantage angles is just like not really super fun. Alright, do we need white? Is there anything double white in our deck? There's Verdict. Might just grab a tap land. I don't really see any reason to opt. Might actually just not cast this opt. I don't even think I'm going to cast this opt. I don't really feel like there's anything I'm looking for at the moment. Like, I have my third land drop. Opt. My opponent is going to cast their opt. Like, I already have, like, a reasonable curve of spells. Just draw a Teferi 3 and you can't lose. This is going to get spell snared. What the hell? Jamming this is really strange. Also, Storm is very strange. Like, what year is it? Like, you're not good against Phoenix. In general, you're just a worse Phoenix deck. You're bad against Phoenix, and you're only a little bit faster than Phoenix is. Anyway, I'm supposed to do this. Excited that Spell Snare had a target. And now that we know what we're looking for in this matchup, I'm pretty excited to cast this Opt. Boop. Detention Sphere. I don't think they main deck empty the Warren, so I think this card is more likely to be bad, and I want to hit more land drops, so I'm going to bottom it. Oust. Oust is fine. Answers creatures. Yeet. All right. I wonder how this deck fares against Narset. Let's find out. I'm going to look for a Force of Negation. Cryptic Command. Teferi 3. That's pretty good. Is Teferi 3 better than Cryptic Command? I don't think so. Go. I'm not going to probably minus this again. Oh, sure. Deal. I'm probably not going to minus this again. I just conceded. Wow, I'm playing a combo deck. I have combo killed my opponent on turn 3. Busted. Busted. Narset against Storm, yeah, no kidding. Oh yeah, Little Teferi in the Mirror also sounds repulsive. Not interested. So Graveyard Hate's traditionally pretty good against them, but I don't really know what their sideboard plan is. I think they have a lot of Arias now, so I'm probably going to want Celestial Purge. I don't think this deck's going to be on the sideboard guide, but I guess I can look. Where is that? Is it on a discard? No, it's on this. Here we go. Dredge. Why? This is organized so badly. Shockingly, there is no control on the sideboard guide. So I'm just going to kind of make it up. I do want Mentor here. This is a matchup where I think I'm going to want to attack pretty quickly. I think I do want Purge for the Aria Flames. Definitely want Veto. Definitely want Stroke. Stroke might be bad. I'm not sure how bad, but we'll find out. And I want some number of recipes. I'm not sure 4 is the answer. Maybe like 2? 3? I don't know if I want 4. The card's not impactful enough, I think, to want 4. And like, I kind of also want my Snapcasters to work some subset of the games. How much do I got? I got a minute. We also already have Surgical Extraction as like Graveyard Hate. Like, that already feels kind of good enough. This card seems like an obvious no. I definitely want Detention Sphere for like the random Empty the Warrens and also, Also, Aria Flame. But I don't think I want Supreme Verdict. It's just a little expensive. It does pitch to Force, which, like, is a pretty good test. Jace and Teferi are kind of expensive. I'm going to keep Teferi around, but I think I'm going to shave on Jace because it's hard to hold up counter magic. Oh, I got a minute. It's hard to hold up counter magic, and I just don't want to cut that many cards. Spell Snare is a little underwhelming, but it does counter Remand and all the creatures. Not sure how many of the creatures they're going to have in. Oust depresses me. I don't think I want all the paths. I think I'm going to cut Spell Snare. I think I'm going to do something like this. Supposed to stop rips for snaps? That's not true at all. Although I do have 4 snaps. I'll cut one. Bring in another one. I don't think that's true at all. I think most of the time, like, dude, I have Rest in Peace and Snapcaster Mage in my decks all the time. I think it's fine. It still attacks. All right, we're going to try this. Still attacks. Still, like, is going to matter, hopefully, like, with counter spells before the Rest in Peace actually comes up. Well, I have a lot of Narsets. I have 2 lands and a 24-land deck. No ways to draw more lands. Force of Negation is a really attractive keep, especially alongside Narset and a path. I think I might keep this, even though my mana is awful. How am I a 2-color deck with mana problems? How is this something that is happening to me? Hello, Teddy. I want to trim Snap over Snare here. Maybe. Rest in peace. Okay. Go. You draw basically any land by turn 3, so I think I have like 3 steps at it, right? So I like my odds. Finally left in Baral. Okay. Think I'm gonna rest in peace. I could path. Does the extra land matter here? It does let them cast Gifts a turn early. Maybe I'll just pass on their upkeep. If they have Remand, then whatever. Actually, we might just pass. I just want to pass. And then we can, like, cast it in step or whatever. I don't want a path on their upkeep. I want a path on their end of turn. We'll take our point. You know what I mean. Casting a ritual of Morphos. Makes 3 mana, which lets you empty. I don't want you to empty. If this gets remanded, it's a little embarrassing, but I guess we could force the remand. In fact, I might. Being able to untap a Narset's really attractive. Playing against the Storm Pony, you just lost to him. Neat. I got baited. Sure. Alright, Surgical Extraction. It's not a shabby one. Probably going to want to surgical them before we make decisions. Narset. I'm going to minus it. Purge. Logic not. Glad we held this. Rest in peace. Grab Logic Knot. Okay, go. God, it's so nice being able to just like tap out against the Storm deck. That is fine. I'm gonna let them, I'm not gonna draw another card off this. I'm just gonna let them attack it for a million turns. That's ritual. That's good to me. Pieces of the puzzle. Might should force this. I don't really know. Kind of want them to fill their graveyard. Don't really care. Don't care. Bolt Slight. You got it. They can bolt the Narset. Think I'm cool with that too. All right. Perfect. Pretty happy actually with the way that turn played out. Could rip them. Not super interested in ripping them though. Narset. Remand. Okay. All right. Still don't really want to make any moves. Happy with them having to reactively remand us. Like, on Arch. What the heck? Leave up 5 mana? Sure. What are you doing? Pyretic Ritual. I don't know why you need mana. Why would they need mana? I don't know. Could be passive flamesing me. Yeah, let's force that. Boop. Pitch. Derp, 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 derp. Narset. Now I feel so smart for them not having burned, or for them having burned their remand. Do they have another one? Gifts! Okay. Are we dead? No! You sound fantastic on my new sound system. Why, thank you, Anarchy. I think that's good. I don't know why they're gifts in here. I mean, I get wanting to resolve their gifts, but like, I'm not going to give them a counterspell. And I don't think there's a stack where they can force a counterspell, even if they have Dispel in their deck. Remand. So if they remand their past in flames, I'm cool with that. They remand my force, I'll force pitch again. So we give them remand Morphos and bin Pierce empty. Yeah. Manamorphose. And now we get them by surgicaling remand. Boop! Gotcha! Ugh. If you could politely taste it, that would be super. I'll take that one. And that one. And, oh, that one too. Alright, now let's get a look at the deck. Snip. Actually, let's get the Exile too. No. Although, I don't think we're going to keep playing this game for long. I suspect this game is over. Boop. But, we got them. What a stack. Modern's so fun. Look at all this stack play. Alright, two more bolts, two grave shots. They have another empty. That's insanity. How many gifts are left in their deck? That was a one of? Are you kidding me with this? Fine. Look at this calculated sideboarding. Okay, is this the only Passive Flames too? We're about to exile the only Passive Flames? That's kind of sicko. Actually, very helpful too.
Okay.
Alright, your Manamorphose resolves. Exile that, cast your Slight, everything makes sense. Down to two cards, you're kind of low on resources. Yeet, Monastery Mentor. I would rather be able to play two things in one turn, but I also kind of want to be able to defend my Narset. Leetle. Let's see. We know nothing in their hand. Oh, Drake, against Graveyard Heat, Storm trims down to one Gifts and one Piff on the empty plan. Seems reasonable. You want a Rip plus Knot? I have bad news for you about how Logic Knot and Rest in Peace work together. Not well. It is not well. Knot is not a combo. It is not a combo. And there's no reason to play Rest in Peace because there's no longer anything in their deck that uses the Graveyard. They don't have any Noxious Revivals. That was their only pass in Flames. So they have nothing. This Rest in Peace is now a prowess trigger for Monastery Mentor. I'm going to put them on having nothing. And play a Mentor. I guess I should have, like, Field of Ruin to them last turn, right? Is that something I should have done? Probably. Hopefully you don't have a Lightning Bolt. Force of Negation exiling is also disgusting. Aria Flame. No! Alright, fine. Fine. Celestial Purge is in my deck, right? Yeah, I do. I also have Detention Sphere in my deck. I think I'm going to burn a Narset trying to find an answer. Gives the most looks. Also allows us to put pressure on them, which is kind of nice. Something that answers an Aria Flame. Well, I mean, Force Negation has text, which is better than the rest of these cards. Combat. I'm going to attack. Would you like to block? Wonderful. I think I'm gonna opt now. Boop. Always yield. Make stuff. Monastery Mentor. What the crap? I don't know if we're gonna be able to race them. Nah, I'd rather try to find an answer to Aria. I don't think racing is a realistic plan. Although, now all I suppose are reactive. Which kind of sucks. Because this Narset's like 100% to die. I mean, we're going to counter basically anything. We're going to pitch this Logic Knot, and then that way we can cast Rest in Peace proactively. But, what is this? Yeah, that is getting very countered. Yeah, see ya. Bye! Spew stuff. Alright, this will put our wonderful Narset to one. No, they should have a ritual or something? Empty. Even better. Man, those are some good draw steps. Now racing gets really hard. Well, rip. We might actually lose this game, which is like pretty frustrating. Maybe I should have like kept the Celestial Purge at one time. Like, I think I took a Logic Knot over Celestial Purge. I haven't played anything yet. Maybe we should attack with everybody. Is this insanity? You think they're gonna quadruple block? I feel like they should. Yeah. This all makes sense. That block makes less sense. Okay. Sure, I'll play the land. Why not? I don't think we have. We have Jace Brainstorms for later. Is this real life? D-Sphere off the dizzy. Yeah, no kidding. Just go, huh? It'd be like that sometimes. Nice. Good deck building. Well. How many turns till we die? A lot. I think we're still just gonna pass. I wonder what they're drawing. How is the game playing out like this? Blow that up. Grab a white source. Play the Snapcaster Mage. Try to set up for a lethal attack. Cryptic Command. It's a pretty good one. That is a pretty good one. So they just die if this works. So we should... They have no remands in their deck. Spell Pierce is exiled. What's left that counters this? Anything? They have one Spell Pierce and they're 75. I'm not mana leaking my Snapcaster Mage. Or it could be Luke Ask. Whatever. Lucas, thank you much for the follow. I really appreciate it. Alright, yeah, we're just gonna counter tap. We're just gonna tap your team draw card. Hail Mary, hope it works. I don't really think we're in a position to win the game if we just sit here. And they only have one Spell Pierce in their deck, and I don't really want to take draw steps. Taste it, Storm. You're probably right, chat. When was that? Many moons ago. Chat's been right before. Come on, don't slander me like this. Alright, 1-0, beat the Storm. Actually, this matchup used to be, I think, insanely in Storm's favor. And, like, I think we really got to see the changes to the Blue Eye Control deck really matter in that game. Where, like, okay, we had Narset that was impactful, and, like, literally stole game one on its own. We had Force of Negation that was the champion of that game, of game two. So, like, all the new developments that Blue Eye Control has gotten in the matchup has, like, really, really swung it in Blue White's favor. And I think that's just, like, another reason on the pile of reasons why I don't think Storm is very good in Modern right now. Man, you just got all these quotes. It's just like spit out a random quote when you do exclamation point quote. That's sicko. I have snap and rip in my deck all the time. It's fine. I appreciate that quote ad. I think that's a good quote. Because it's very true. It's very, very true. Oh, I love to see it. Look at this. I got a Temple of Tilt on turn one. Keep. Can't lose. Cannot lose. Here you go. Here's my Temple. Taste it. Monkey Yang over here is like, yes, my opponent doesn't know what a modern playable deck looks like. Nice. Alright. Who'd you target? Should target yourself, right? Yeah. Look at this. Look at this scry. Look at this scry action. I suspect this is not going to be a matchup where Force Negation is good. This looks like a shadow deck. This is, in fact, a shadow deck. Tilt! Shadow should be a good matchup, but we don't have any Paths in our hand. Ugh, they're going to take Mana Leak. It's almost worth it to just, like, Force Pitch Cryptic, because I feel like those spells aren't going to matter, but Card Advantage matters in this matchup, so we're going to sit here. First time catching you live. Hey, a Juice Box! Thank you very much for catching me live. I appreciate your support. All right, yeah, draw your card. Narset. It's not as good as I'd want it to be, actually. Because they can line all their crap up exactly to where it works well. Blech. We're going to need to draw land. With the Mana Leak, I figured we could miss for a turn. Now that we have been stripped of our Mana Leak, I am less confident. This puts you to 13, not quite Shadow Range. But Gurmag range, right? No, still a card short of Gurmag. Arcanist. Yikes. All right, now would be an awesome time to spike a land for this Teferi. Let me tell you what. We're actually not going to fetch for that reason. Land! Damn it! No! All right, fine. I think we're going to lose this one, chat. We did not draw a Path to Exile. We just let this happen, probably. Probably. Although we have an excess of cards. Maybe not. Good force at pitching Cryptic. I'm almost kind of in. Nah. It's the only spell in their graveyard. See, look at this deck building. This draw step decided the game. Yeah, no kidding. Hey, Drake. Do I have to pay you to play a beam deck that actually works? Yeah. That is... Yeah. Yeah. You do. Well, it depends. Yeah, I mean, yeah. Yeah. No! They're shadowing. So much board presence. On time, pal. You're on fucking time. I guess we just spin the Narset looking for... like, we fetch an island here, spin the Narset looking for a Supreme Verdict, and just try to get that online. And then we can protect it using Force Negation. Supreme Verdict! Supreme Verdict! Path to Exile definitely qualifies. If we draw land now, we can pass that path. Also very good. And if they discard spell me, we definitely force it, because it keeps them from Arcanisting it as well. Right now, their Arcanist is just a 1-3. You got it. Targeting me? Yeah. This deck is so sexy, though. Surgical Teferi? What are you, Surgical Teferi, Mana Leak, Flood? Dude, I do not care. I mean, I guess it gives you some extra, like, it lets you hit harder. I don't think we can die even with a Team or Battle Rage, right? Like, let's say they have Cycle Shrieker plus Team or Battle Rage, we're still not dead? So I feel like it incentivizes them to attack Narset with the Shadow. Otherwise, we're going to roll it into another card. Get this. It's a Tron deck with Urza. What are you doing? Tron is... See, this is how you know Tron lands are busted. Is if you can just do whatever you want with them, that is fine. Dismember your thing. Hit me for 16. You should be short. Mutagenic. So if we force this... If we don't force this, I think we die, right? Yeah, if we don't force this, we die. So we have to force this. Boop. Boop. Maybe we should just force the Battle Rage. I don't know. I didn't really think the Battle Rage mattered. I thought it was just going to be like a burn spell that wasn't really going to have text. Surgical Mana Leak. What is that? 8, 16, 17. Put me to 1. All right. I mean, I can still win. I can still win. Requires them not to draw a removal spell, obviously. Just surgical all the things. It's fine. You can surgical whatever you want. Surgical all my things. I do not care about any of the cards you're surgicaling. I kind of care about Strand, but you're about to send me to 1. You almost shouldn't even surgical my Strands. Alright. With this on the stack, since we know we have to path, we're going to go ahead and path. Well, they could have Bloodbraid off in their deck. I'm not thinking it's likely. Not really sure what this plays around. Probably should have waited them for their draw their card. Ooh, Glacial Fortress. You don't hate to see it. You don't hate to see it, chat. Snapcaster Mage. Target path. All those surgicals, and I'm still pathing you with a Snapcaster Mage. Wild. Alright. I'm at one. Never draw a bolt. Well, at least not until we draw a counterspell. Please. Ooh, they only have one basic? That's nice to know. Take that. Go! Mushroom should be like, bolt you, huh, idiot. Op's a good one. Think I'm gonna hold it for now, because I don't really know what I need. I guess I kind of want to land, right? So I can snap Force Negation for the bolt they draw. But doesn't really do me any good this turn. Draws the check land. Yeah, that was some good deck building. Check lands are so good. Although I would have hit the path anyway off the Narset. But, you know, the deck building was important too. We're going to opt, snap opt is what we're going to do. What are you doing? Dismember. I almost want to path it. Nah, I'm off it. We're just going to opt, snap opt. Bottom that. Blue, Snapcaster Mage. Opt. Okay, blue, opt. Look for counterspell. Perfect! Alright. Timely! I actually have less life than my opponent. That's kind of sicko. How timely. Timely! Gain 6. Combat. Itcha. Now we're not dead to bolt, and I don't know what actually kills us, so we're just going to keep passing the turn. Face when your opponent's at 3 and you have less life than your opponent's, the timely works. Nice! I'm owning! Yeah, this match was pretty good. We got hit for a billion and, like, probably played badly and still we're, like, winning. Rest in peace. Looks like it might have merit. Once again, I'm not sure how many I actually want. Shadow, is Shadow on this guide? Let's look at Shadows in the Cyber Guide. Alright, here, I'll let you look with me, chat. Look with me. Look. Look with your special eyes. Do we see Shadow? I do not. Alright, we tried. Could also just be dumb. I'm owning! What's up, Rob? How's it going? You're casting Emrakul and Ulamog for free. Just spin the Urza wheels. Angel actually seems kind of fine. Timely does not seem very good. Could be good. Skip 3, 5, 7. Thank you much for the follow. I really appreciate it. I basically just want everything that kills a creature, right? And, like, Timely could be kind of reasonable. It's not good, but it chump blocks. It's not very good against Team or Battle Rage, but I feel like they should probably take that out of their deck. Alright, let's just look at what's bad. I don't think counterspells are very good in this matchup at all. So I'm actually going to cut, like, these. Cut, like, a Cryptic and, like, a Narset. Narset not impacting the board is pretty bad. Force Negation is also really bad. It looked okay that game, but it could have been a removal spell, and the card did not look good. Surgical also sucks. Spell Snare is probably actually fine. Does this give them 3 life? Oh, it gives them 3 life! Oust is so good! Vendilion Clique's a reasonable one. Alright, we get to bring one of these cards in. Could be like a Mentor, just like make some blockers. That could be fine. Maybe it's better than Timely, it's just like things that make blockers, like Mentor. I don't know. Kind of making this up. Baby Tef is nuts. Baby Tef is like fine against Shadow, right? Like it impacts the board. That's like reasonable. I'm just going to cyber like this. We're going to take out all the counter spells except for like 2 Cryptics. Just going to like... And a Spell Snare. Spell Snare is good on the draw. We can catch their Arcanist. Ooh, his hand is great. Teferi kind of sucks. It's a billion mana, but whatever. We're going to let them just kind of spin their wheels and die. Monkeying. Monastery Sphere. All right, sure. Hit me for 3 on turn 1. Okay. Crack 1. What am I drawing? A Snapcaster Mage? It's reasonable. We're going to fetch a Plains with this if they make it any bigger than one power, I think. Okay. Should be targeting you, right? Yeah, I guess she's supposed to target me. I'm almost certainly going to fetch. Cycle. You got it. Fetch. Greenweaver, thanks for the follow. I really appreciate it. It means a lot. I'm doing karaoke at a bar that's not B-dubs, so it's not a real bar. Oh my god, Rob. Did you hear about that story? Did you hear about us in, what's it called? In Columbia? What the heck? Where's the detention sphere? Alright, well, I'm probably gonna path one just to, like, path one. Planes. Path to exile one of these. Damn, they actually had the mutagenic. I didn't put them on having mutagenics in their deck. I did not think that card would still be in their deck. It just seems so bad. Joke's on me, idiot. They have them all in the deck. Sure, dude. Now I feel super stupid for drawing Narset. Probably gonna flash in a Snapcaster just to, like, block. I don't know if they're out of spells, but... hell, maybe we can win the race. Here's a Snapcaster. Okay. Yeah, we'll block. We're not winning this race. Yeah, they're out of spells. Taste it, which means they have a creature and a big one. Yep, there's a goofer. One goofer. Now we can snap path without taking damage. You don't hate to see it. It's not something you hate to see. Okay. Don't really want to give them a draw to surgical. And they would have surgical. They would have surgical me here. So they don't have the surgical right now. So we should on their upkeep surgical. We should on their upkeep path them. I don't think they're going to have another basic, but hell, you never know. They could board one in. Wouldn't be the craziest thing. Pass priority. What do you? Snapcaster. Alright, we're gonna path the goofer. Hopefully they don't have another basic. They do! Ha! I'm so smart! They either didn't show me the one game one or boarded another one in. Should be kind of insanity. I will block again. Did you draw a spell? You did. What is it? Mutagenic? Veil of Summer. Nice. It cycles. Very, very nice. Did you draw another creature? Did you draw another creature? Probably dead. Shadow? Really? Oh my gosh. It's a rough one, but we have an Narset. Got a high roll into a removal spell. Tilts. Maybe I should have held the path to exile after targeting it. Definitely should have, right? Definitely should have held the path after targeting it. Tis tis. All right, give me Timely. If they have Mutagenic still in their deck, I do want the other Timely. I thought they were going to try to grind with me. I legitimately... get this card in my deck. It's a million mana. I guess they packs the board. Fine. It can stay. Narset is really depressing. But it's kind of card advantage where we're, like, shaving on a lot of our card advantage engines. You want, like, another rip, too? Just cut, like, both Narsets. I think I'm kind of here for that. All right, we'll try this. Where can I get that sideboard sheet? Here, I'll post it in the chat. It was in my Discord. But I will post it in chat as well. You heard about the table? Yeah, that's rough. How Pharaoh left after the first bar to go to B-dubs. Isn't that depressing? Can you imagine going to Buffalo Wild Wings instead of hanging out at, like, pretty nice bars with, like, other, like, cool Magic players? Alright. This hand also slaps. We want to cast our opt on turn one to find lands, so we're going to do that. But it's just wild to me that, like, they still had mutagenic growth in their deck. Not just one, but at least two. I mean, clearly they identified their role as get under me on the play, so... Maybe I'm the big idiot for thinking they're gonna try to grind me when they are on the play. Bobble. This means they do not have land plus Swiss Spear. Means they have a fetch land. Okay. Got the old scry trick, getting to target yourself. It's pretty cute. I always screw that up. Never hand me Mistress Baubles, chat. It's not a pretty sight. That is not a land. Neither is that. I just upgraded how much mana my Teferi costed. It's no bueno. Another opt. Alright, fine. Maybe should opt main phase, try to find it. Like, if mine's a Colonnade, I'm going to, like, do that. Hey! Anonymous! I don't know who Anonymous is, but thank you for the gifted subs. I really appreciate that. Welcome, Mikey Hopkins and Teddy. Really appreciate you guys. Appreciate you guys. No more deserving people than those two. Thank you for your support. And thank you, Anonymous, for gifting. You're very, very generous. Very, very generous. We are Anonymous. Why are they cycling second main? My opponent has played some weird magic, I tell you what. Because, like, what if they hit a Swiss Spear? They're going to want to attack me this turn. Does this mean they don't have Swiss Spear in their deck? I just don't understand. All right, a Shadow. You have another Shadow? Another Shadow. Let's opt. Top. Look at me in the forehead. Okay. So if they have surgical, we get a little boned, but not that boned. Let's just path one of these. They have sixed, so maybe they don't have surgical. Could be what that means. I don't know if I want to snap path or just want a detention sphere. Detention sphere can hit non-creature permanents if they have that, and it could also hit multiples. I could have just tried the Detention Sphere, but I think I want to hold the Detention Sphere for as long as possible in case they have some kind of, like, Planeswalker. Or if they have something that makes tokens. Like, the Shadows are, like, some of the more pathable things. We'll shock this in. It could be wrong. I could be playing scared and should just be greedy with my Detention Sphere, but I really kind of want to... I think I want to take the conservative line and hold it. Look, they played their other basic. Get them. I probably shouldn't let them take a draw step either. If I'm taking this line, I don't think I should let them take a draw step. But, like, I have Snapcaster Mage to where if this... Yeah, this just gets blown to the moon by Surgical. And Veil of Summer. All right. Well, no, Veil of Summer doesn't get blown to the moon by because I can just block. And now I... No, this is actually wrong because I can target Opt. All right. Yeah. Oh, it only has expert from blue and black. Whatever. Let's go to blocks, and that will inform how I need to actually, like, sequence this. Alright. Yeah, that's fine. God, I've played this game very strangely. Maybe they'll play another Shadow. That'd be kind of sicko. Boop. Opt. I don't think Monastery Mentor is very good, right? It could be. Veil of Summer. It's another thing that would have blown me out for the Detention Sphere. I'll take the Mentor, actually. Land! Oh, I'm so greedy and it paid off. That was so greedy. Because now we get to play our own team or Battle Rage. Oh, it's so, so greedy, but whatever. These fear lost value once you pathed? Is that even true? I don't understand why D-Sphere lost value. Because, like, I don't even want to D-Sphere this. I don't understand. Or at least, like, not until we do. I don't know. Yep, not blocking. You should play a goofer. Okay. Hoping they go for a team or battle rage. Or at least if they spew all their resources, just like bolting me, basically. Six, this is 13. Alright, yeah, there's nothing I can really do about that. Take 13, go to 5. They don't have it. That's lame. Spell snare this. Boop! Alright, now we get to run them out of resources and make tokens while doing it. I think we now cannot lose this game. We probably can lose this game for most of the game, but... we can blow up their red source too in the process. Or we can just Teferi. Pretty in love with Teferiing, actually. Could just shoot their red source still, though. Eh. Shoot the red source D-sphere. Nah, I'm just gonna put Teferi. Spend my mana efficiently. Because, like, D-sphere lets me move a blocker out of the way. Because we're just going to attack him. We're going to attack him to 3. And then D-sphere lets us move a blocker out of the way and draw cards. This is going to be a hard one for them to win. Got him. Teferi's so broken. Veil Summer is really good. It looks very good from their side. It hasn't been enough because they're trying to take this aggressive role. Like, honestly, okay. Like, this is what I'm talking about. Look at how this game played out. Like, I understand how game 2 went, but look at how this game played out. They spewed their resources just, like, putting me to a lower life total with, like, Becomements and, like, Mutagenic Growth. Like, these are just cards that they had that, like, they just, like, threw in the garbage can. Like, I don't know necessarily with our hand if they were, like, ever winning this game trying to grind, but, like... I don't know, like, this like, punk me out plan seems like it's asking to get pathed or asking to, like, just get verdict or whatever. Like, it just doesn't seem like, especially if you're bringing in Veil of Summer, this is, like, kind of a keep my things alive, but you don't really gonna have mana to, like, hold it up while you're trying to become immense people, and, like, especially if you're gonna try to team or battle rage people, which I imagine has to be still in their deck if they have all this stuff. I don't know, maybe they just don't have enough cards for the matchup, but, like, it really does not seem like leaving all your pump spells in is what you want against Blue White. Those would be some of the first cards I would cut. Either way, we won. Haha, results oriented. We're busted. Got him. 2-0 with Blue White control. What broken modern format. Hogak sucks. We haven't played against Hogak, but Hogak sucks. Look at this stuff we're playing against. We're playing against Storm and Shadow. We're just gonna... We're being the good guys. The heroes of this. They could be playing Lillian Command. Yeah, exactly. Like, those cards are, like, good in the matchup, right? Like, they're just, like, very card advantage-y, and, like, it's not unreasonable for you to grind me out, at least out of, like, answers. Because, like, I'm probably going to draw more lands than the Shadow deck, right? The Shadow deck is pretty low in lands, and so they get virtual card advantage. The same way Humans beats Black Control. You get virtual card advantage by having all of your, like, spells be real cards and then just drawing less lands than me. And so I'm going to draw a bunch of lands and die while you have, like, one more threat left over that just kills me. And that's just, like, a common play pattern from these, like, threat versus answers decks is, like, you know, my deck has to play a million lands because I have these unacceptably expensive spells for the modern format. And, like, you're just going to you're just going to win as the game progresses. Play against 2-3 decks and win, clearly the best. I actually think, okay, as much as I'm kind of ragging on Shadow, there has been a Shadow deck I've kind of been working on in the background. I think the archetype's pretty well positioned. Like, I think it lines up pretty well against the Tron decks. I think it lines up pretty well against the, like, the Phoenix decks. And I think it has a, like, fast enough Goldfish, especially with Teemer Battle Rage, to be able to compete with the Hogak deck. And so, like, I think it's, like, a strategy that, like, could be set for a comeback. So, I don't know necessarily that it's tier 3. I mean, it's definitely not among the top tier decks. Speaking of not among the top tier decks, this is good Magic. This is what we deserve to look at playing Blue Eye Control. For the old Cryptic Command single Field of Ruin hand. You know what? This hand's got to be keepable, I bet. Just embarrassing. Absolutely embarrassing. Hey, we have no idea if Surgical's good or not, so we'll pitch it, even though it's one of our free spells. And normally, one of the, like, attractive hands in this deck have free spells in them, so... We can't beat Blue Eye on Grixis Death Shadow. Yeah, maybe. I don't know. I lost to it playing Blue White back in the day. And I think the innovations to the deck have only made it worse in the matchup, not better. Find lands. It's not a land. Like, for instance, that card. That card is heinous in the Shadow matchup. Okay. Well, this at least telegraphs mana leak really hard. Because they're probably sitting there like, what did they keep if it doesn't have a mana leak? But they're still going to jam their thing in the ice. What the hell? Is this a different storm person? Are you kidding me with this? What the crap is this? All right, whatever. Whatever, I'm off it. I don't care anymore. Ugh, this is so embarrassing. Well, now we know Surgical would have been good. I mean, pitch a Jace. I'm just going to pass. Now they get the gifts on my turn. This is so gross. Whatever, at least you get to exile their past in flames. Oh my god, do we have 7 cards in the end? Alright, good. Alright, cash your gifts. Get goldfished. Yup. Everyone is storming. What the crap is this? Yeah, I don't understand. This right here is where I don't like Vista. I mean, Vista's fine. If I don't like Field of Ruin for this reason. I don't think we should be pointing at Vista and be like, this is Vista's fault. I think we should be pointing at Field of Ruin. Alright, we're going to bin the Grape Shot. We're going to bin the Metamorphose. The Desperate Rituals aren't real cards. So, like, they won't trade even. And, like, this forces them to cast a Past in Flames, which we can force a negation. Thank you very much for the follow, EC Cooter Crasher. Thank you very much for the follow. I really appreciate it. Bunch of mana. I'ma make a bunch of mana. My name's Storm Guy. I'ma exile that. Goodbye. Exile Jason Mind Sculptor because the card has no freaking text. Goodbye. See ya. Goodbye. Bye-bye, Passive Flames. Goodbye. Goodbye now. They have another gift for Fairy Dead, though. Are they just passing? They spewed their load and they're just passing. You love to see it, chat. You love to see it. Although we are on the 18 turn. We're on the 18 turn. I hope we draw an island. We deserve to draw a basic island. Okay, or a Temple of Tilt. That too. We also deserve to draw that. Islet's a nice inclusion, actually. That's a good one for this Storm deck. Because they used to play Shivan Reef. All right, more shitters. Noted. Okay, you got the beats. All right. Field of Ruin. Ah! All right, we're probably just going to Field of Ruin, like, Field of Ruin Path. I don't know. Probably, yeah, we're probably just going to Field of Ruin Path. Probably going to path the Electromancer in step, because it's the one that can actually have multiples of. I don't know, maybe I want them to have multiples of it. Okay. We're going to grab an island, that way we can hold up Cryptic. So many lands. What do you have? Gifts Ungiven. Gifts Ungiven. We can't path snap path, but we can path here. Oh, and pathing here means that what? I don't know. I think pathing here helps. Right? No, it doesn't. Could snap opt. That's the fucking ballsy play. Looking for a Surgical or a Force Negation. So we have two. We have three draws to draw to. Two Lux. Damn it. We needed one more turn. Or for Field of Ruin to be a playable goddamn land. I need to decide now if I want a path or not. Don't think I do. I think we're just going to have to let this happen. I mean, I'm going to hope they screw this up. If they don't screw this up, we're going to snap opt looking for Surgical or Force Negation for their last pass of flames. Yeah, I mean, bin the not rituals. We've decided we're not fighting on a mana axis. They did not fuck up their gifts pile. Okay. Okay. Opt. Whoa. snap opt here. Snapcaster Mage. Target opt. Okay, we get two looks at three cards. Let's do it. Although, if we top, it's so obvious what we have, and I wonder if they just pass. Oust. That ain't it, Chief. Damn it. Alright, maybe they're a robot and we'll figure out how to kill me. Not holding my breath. What's Storm 7? 10. They got me, chat. ViralDrake, was fun hanging out this weekend. Yeah, I had a good time. Gifts was bare plus your mana's dead. I'm aware, I played Storm for a long time. I actually missed my win and in for top 8, which I already thought I had top 8. I was 7-1 in a modern classic with Storm. Missed top 8. But I did cash an invitational with Storm as well. I played a lot of Storm. Unfortunately, I also know how bad other Storm players are, and they're not good. They're not good at all. Alright, we want Purge. Purge. Rip. Rip. I think I want more answers to empty. If they're boarding into the empty plan and that's common enough, then I think I'm gonna leave in all my verdicts and might actually bring this in too. I'm a monster. You don't even know me. You know what I'm about. Spell Snare's great. Narset's fine. Click's insane. Teferi's fine. All cards are good. Maybe I don't want to leave Verdict then. Verdict gets a pitch to Force at least. I don't think I want Wrath. I also don't think I want all four rips. I think I still want like two rips. Mind Sculptor still depresses me. Timely sucks. We'll cut like a snap. Since chat was complaining about that. Cut like a path or two. Oh, this is worse. Cryptic Command's great. These cards are great. I'm going to cut two more cards. What do I want to cut? Oh, Jace kind of sucks. Get Jace out of my deck. Teferi also kind of sucks. But he's a good answer to Aria, so I kind of want to leave him in. I just want to like maximize the answers to Aria. I'm not looking to play around with this stupid Aria card. These Spell Snares kind of sucks. It's fine, right? It's fine. Three Teferi seems bad, actually. Does it? It bounces. Fine. We'll cut one. It seems fine. It seems fine. I don't know why you're hating on 3-mana Teferi. I don't think it's insane, but it does seem fine. What'd you like to play first? Nothing made me happier. Literally nothing. Free spell. Snap keep. We're behind on time, too. This match used to be really grindy. I can't believe we played Storm twice. This is insanity. What are these people doing? Like, this is coming from Blue Light Control guy. What are you doing? Storm is not a playable deck anymore. All right, my turn. Ooh, that was a good draw. Debating playing Island or just playing Flooded Strand. I'm going to play Island. I don't really know what I want to fetch with this Flooded Strand yet. Because, like, if I draw a Field of Ruin, I want a Hallowed Fountain. Otherwise, I don't know if I want a Plains. I really don't want a Plains. But I do want a second white. I don't know. I'm kind of okay just, like, mana leaking this. Sure, we'll counter it. I'm feeling countering it. Especially because we're going to have Force of Negation hard cast up next turn. Oh, yeah. You love to see it. You love to see it, chat. And if we have to hard cast Force of Negation, then whatever. Although, I think... What is this? A Brawl? Upt. I want to bottom that, actually. Okay. Morphos. Yep, I'm that. What if we need gifts? This actually lets them empty, but we have verdict, so I don't care if they empty. Okay. Yeah. Maybe I should have surgicaled the morphoses. I don't really know. Okay. Pieces. I'm gonna hope they stumble into an empty kill. Or they did. So stumble into an Aria Flame. Okay. So this lets us curve verdict. Yep. Perfect. Ruining. Look at this, chat. And a land. Wow, we're gods. Now we can Teferi next turn. And tuck their Aria. Which I know is in their hand, right? No, they had to go to the graveyard because pieces of the puzzle can't grab it. That's just bad deck building. Verdict all your crap. Go. Gotcha. Alright. I don't know what's in their hand, but I'm probably just going to jam this Teferi because I have no self-control. Boop. Jam. Get remanded. Peer through depths? Are you looking for a spell pierce? Oh, you drew pieces. That's fine. We will untap a land. We'll untap two lands. And we drew a spell snare? Jeez. Okay. That one and that one. Turn's yours. Maybe we should untap Plains Island to play around Blood Moon. Pieces. I don't know if I really care about this. I am having trouble understanding if I care about this or not. Like, a divination, is that something I would counter? I don't think so. Especially because it bends Arias. They whiffed. They literally just whiffed. They put no cards in their hand. It was a mill five. Wow. Some good deck building there. Oh my god. All right. And now this game is what you would call squarely over. They've drawn a lot of their basics too. Oh, I guess I should float mana. Sacrifice, blow that land up. Wait. Cancel. Blow that land up. Use this and this. Grab an island. And then we let this happen and untap this and this, and we blow up their other land. Yeah. We'll grab Plains. Why not? Actually, there's probably legitimately very good reasons why not, and I'm probably just screwing it all up. But I do what I want. I try to run them out of red sources. We have a win condition. Teferi's a win condition. We're just getting some other freaking lands. We're just going to plus this Teferi into the moon, and then they're going to die. It's going to be a great time. I think they just failed to find. Yep. Pyretic Ritual. Kind of just want to spell snare that. Time to spell snare that. Because we can't really beat an empty terribly well. I don't know. Let's surgical empty. Let's surgical empty. Yeah, because we can beat Aria, but we can't beat empty. So let's just surgical empty. Let's see what their hand does. Let's have a look-see. I think it was an empty. I think they had an empty in their hand. Not, I don't really know what's cueing me in on that, but I think they had an empty. All right. So, do I want another answer to empty the warrens? Kind of do. It's nice that this like picks up the creatures with it. Does Little Teferi just like really suck? We got 1, 2, 3, 4 answers to Aria of Flame and like a billion D counterspells for it. This counterspell kind of sucks. I just want to board it out. What if I just like next level just didn't bring in Rest in Peace at all? Is that insanity? And just like kept Snapcaster Mage? That feels like insanity. But I want to do it. I'm going to do like this. Is Rest in Peace better than Teferi? I don't know. Like I feel like if they're smart, they would just board back into like graveyard stuff. I'm doing it. We're going to try it. I'm going to make no decisions. Do you not see the 4-4? Yeah, no kidding. Celestial Colonnade. That's literally a Baneslayer. Not a Baneslayer Angel. It's a Sarah Angel. What is with these one fielder enhanced? I feel like we've had a like disproportionate amount of these. Like, I don't know how likely this is to happen as fielder is your only land, but we've had two on our stream so far, and maybe even three. And I just feel like that's disproportionately, like, happening. Oh my god, I didn't board out any lands. Alright, the old mold of five. It'd be like that sometimes, too. Keep. Functional hands are hard to mulligan. Teferi's got to go. Cryptic or Verdict? I feel like Verdict is more likely to be live longer. Done. That's fine. Yeah, I'll play Colonnade, and then we can play Field Array next turn. Well, it is good mana base. This mana base is great. I love this mana base. This is so good. So good. Such modern power level. Wow. Wow. Teferi, Time Raveler. Yeah, it'd be like that sometimes. Cool. Like, I can't counter stuff if they make a bunch of mana. God. Not countering it. Oh, God. We're 100% to get emptied. This sucks. Pieces. Can I mana leak that? Could mana leak that. But mana leaking that doesn't even do a ton, right? Nah, I'm just gonna let it happen. Well, they got a peer through depths. Wait, what happened? I don't understand. Oh, they put a pieces and a ritual in their hand. They're just gonna keep going off this. Aria of Flame? Damn. Okay. I want them to cast some spells into this. Oh, Jesus Christ. Well, let's mana leak a copy. Here, we'll just mana leak the original so we can have six. 10, 28. So I think we need to draw an untapped land. We get to like verdict everything. That counts. So if we shock, we can bounce Aria of Flame. But I think I want them to be able to cast some spells. I don't know. Does that keep us alive longer? I don't know. I don't know anything. Drake's dumb. Because like I can hope to not die, untap verdict, pass, hope not to die, untap, hope to draw a land, and then we get Teferi, Logic Knot. This feels like it's a big ask. So we're taking 11. Yeah, let's just Teferi it. We lose our Teferi, but hopefully this will buy us enough time. Alright, well, there's the land. I guess we would have drawn the land. Now I feel like a forehead. I don't think it's fine. We know they have a pieces of the puzzle in their hand. Like, that's just so many cards to get something going off Aria. Oh my god, just swing the Baral here. What are you doing? Just attack all and then pull one back. And then you play Aria again? Oh no, you're just piecesing. Some spells. Surgical. So what'd they put in their hand? Death Ritual, Electromancer. They say put Morphos Opt. Alright, so we know they have a Morphos and an Opt in their hand. So let's lead off with a verdict. Alright, now we can shoot their Morphos. And that saves us something. I'm just going to exile Morphos. Put me to 14. Gets a card out of their hand. All right, they have Morphos. Another empty. Jeez. Whatever. They don't have any mana. This is going to be a tough game to win. Though mulling to 5 typically does that. All right. 2 grape shots in their deck. A wipe away? Sure, dude. All right. Oh. Gosh, I did not think they would have the other empty in their hand. Did I know that? Is there a way I could have known that? Maybe so. Play Aria.
Surgical. Well, that's a pretty damn good one. That is a pretty fucking good one. Empty the Warrens. Empty. They drew a grape shot? Jeez. Stop! Okay. We could shoot their thing, but that just lets them opt. It lets them be mana efficient. So, just gonna hold off on that. That idea. We're gonna need some help. In fact, I probably should counter this opt. Blue. I guess I'm not really planning on fielding this turn. Although we're gonna play around Sculptors. It's gonna be the last card in main, so there's no reason to hold up mana. Oh, that needs to be blue. I'm such a forehead. One, two. I guess I should have fetched too. Gosh, because I'm probably doing that. All right, cancel it all. Cancel it all. Cancel it all. You know. Cancel it all. Cancel it all. Just, you know how it'd be. All right. That spell. This has, like, been the hardest thing about this deck so far, has been trying to figure out how to cast this. If they drew a ritual, do we want to play around that? Sure. There we go. We played around them drawing a ritual. Hit me for one. Boop. What's up, Brock Kess? How's it going? All right, they're going to grape shot me. They're down. They're low on resources, so we just need to find an answer to Aria in probably like 3-ish turns. And that helps race. But we're still a little short of actually being able to win this race. Then crack islets. Yeah, they should start cracking these islets. Oh, that's so good, right? Is that good? I think that's good. Attack you. All right, you're at 10. Go. They didn't crack any islets. I guess they're trying to play around Field of Ruin? I don't really understand. Brawl. So what happens if we snap Mana Leak this? It is a blocker. Yeah, I think I'm going to snap Mana Leak this because it's a blocker. Mana Leak, this, blue. I guess I should have done Logic Knot and just exiled my whole graveyard. Just like, because I think that's more, but because it plays around, once again, them drawing a ritual. Does he have another one? There's another creature. Oh, okay. If I draw a land, are they dead? I don't know. I don't know if they're dead. Hi-ya! They're dead in two, that's for sure. Here we go. Look at this. Look at this aggressive plan. We are blue-white aggro. Yeah, they were dead if I drew a land. Tilt. What is this? Is this a spell that is going to get countered? Yes, it is. Wow. Look at this. All right. Blue. White. Counter that. I don't know what you're doing, but I don't want you using your mana, and I'm off it. I'm off it. Bam! Take that, Storm. I can't believe we won this game. That was insane. That was insane. But Blue-White Control is obviously a busted Magic the Gathering deck. And so, as someone that is now 2-0 against Storm, you know, I feel confident saying that my deck is broken. Because Storm is a combo deck that kills you on turn 3 in the Modern format. And now we all know Modern is a turn 3 format, right? And so, Blue-White Control actually also wins the game on turn 3. But sometimes it can even win the game, like, on turn 2, like my turn 2. Because what they do is they go for a turn 3 kill, and I just force it, and then they die. But also, every deck loses to Narset, obviously. So, on my turn, if I'm on the play, they lose on their turn 2, like my turn 3, where I just Narset them, and they concede the game. And so, basically, Blue Eye Control is the best deck in the format, and that's the only conclusion I can really draw here.
Gabe Nasifu, I don't know. I think he's some scrub. Does he even play his deck? What does he do? He probably like 3-2s leagues. Like, oh, we're going to 5-0 and we're going to show him what's up. I haven't seen Mentor in a blue-white deck in a while. Yeah, it's pretty good. It's good sideboard tech. It's good sideboard tech. I don't think I have I even used the sideboard guide yet? You gave me Shadows, you gave me a sideboard guide, and I don't think I've used it at all yet. I just have had no matchups that have been on the sideboard guide. 5-0 has been called. Yeah, I mean, our deck's busted. Of course we're going to 5-0. Like, come on. Come on. Our deck's broken. Like, we have free spells. Surgical Extraction is, look at this, a free spell. We now cannot lose the Hogak because we have a free spell that says they lose the game on it. See, Goof MTG is what we're going to do to them. We're going to goof them. We're going to goof them. Although we don't have any Tarmogoyf goofs in our deck. Snap Keep. Look at this hand. Busted. Busted. So, so broken. I can't wait to win on turn 3. Look, they're mulliganing too. How do we lose? Oh, God, help. Oh, make it stop. Now would be a good time to have our Force of Negations, huh? chat help. You playing Doom Switches list? I don't know. You can type exclamation point Decklist. They just let the mana fizzle? Are you kidding me with this? No. There's no way. What? They just threw 3 mana away. How? How is this what is happening to them? All right, well, we need help. And we need it, like, now. Anything that says counter a spell on it, please. Ding! Top. I would like to top that Magic the Gathering card, please. All right, put this into play on tap because our deck's broken. Pass. God, we could blow up their Waterlogged Grove with this field around, too. That's so good. We're so professional. I don't know how they ever win this game. We're just so good. We're so, so good. Gonna blow the memories away. Now I feel undone. So this game's like over, right? Yeah, I don't know what their win strategy is. I'm not claiming to be an expert by any means, but I don't really know what the hell this is either. Rampaland. Okay. What the fuck? Alright, I mean, go. Unfortunately, we can't just aggressively field this Waterlogged Grove like you'd kind of want to, but, I mean, we're so far ahead that it doesn't particularly matter. Oh, they're just going to cycle it anyway. Perfect. Now we have a target. Alright, let's go to instep. Let's blow this up because we want them to use their gemstone mine. Gonna blow my memories away. Now I feel undone. And now we have Cryptic Command up, and I definitely have no idea how they win the game around that. So. Don't really want to expose my other field rune, actually. Kind of want them to, like, do stupid stuff with their lands. Although, it just occurred to me we could Shermine them. They didn't find a basic. I thought they played 2. Oh, God, I'm such an idiot. Forehead. Whatever, never mattered. Cryptic Command this. Never mind. Not Cryptic Commanding that. The old Morphos Pass. Don't hate to see it, chat. Don't hate to see it. Concede. They just don't even want to play. They have no interest in continuing this game. I don't blame them, because this is like, pretty sure this is squarely in the unwinnable territory, but wild. Just wild, chat. Just wild. All right, as you can see, my deck's busted. I mean, it took us a little longer than it normally does to win. Like, we won on turn 4. But that's okay, because, like, you know, our deck sometimes, you know, doesn't get it all together, and we don't always just combo kill them as quickly as we'd like, but we still made it happen. Disdainful Stroke counters Noxious. Like, is that ever something we're trying to do? Probably not, right? This blocks a Grizzlebrand. This attacks through Grizzlebrand and blocks Grizzlebrand. I'm putting it in my deck. I'm not kidding. Celestial Purge sucks. Because I feel like we have to have enough bad cards, right? Like, this card is heinous. This card is heinous. This card's nutso. I don't know how I beat that one. Teferi's a win condition, so I'm probably going to leave it in my deck. Pitches to Force. Actually, I might just take it out. It's like the most expensive win condition. Oust is unplayable. Paths are unplayable. Maybe I'll leave like one in. I'll leave one in case they have some kind of sideboard juke. Spell Snare counters Neoform, so it's very good. Apparently, Teferi actually does make the cut because it is better than all these cards. All right, so now we got the slim pickings. Stroke. Take out all the white cards. We're so good at this game. Yeah, I'm professional. So I'm looking at Legacy Challenge decks. Jun got 8th in the last challenge. Jun devolved. Dude, Jun's broken. Broken. Oh, I guess Stroke does counter Allosaurus Rider. You're so right. You're so right. Snowship is busted, Hunter. What are you talking about? Hey, Moon Rabbit. How's it going? I am sideboarding and doing the most calculated sideboarding decisions that a single individual can make. Sure, we'll just put this crap in our deck. This has to be worse than Path. I refuse to believe it was not better than... All right, here we go. Put Path back in our deck. This sucks. This pitch is a Force. Golly, we have no cards this matchup. I wonder why. Probably because it's very good for us. Going fine. We're playing broken decks in Modern. Broken. I heard Modern is a broken format. Wins on turn 3, so we're playing the most busted of the decks that can win on turn 3. Something tells me this is not going to be good enough on the draw. So I'm going to mulligan. We only have 2 Forces in our deck. But a turn 2 counterspell is better, I think. I think? Might just not be. I'm going to mulligan again. Keep! Put 2 cards on bottom. See ya. Probably see ya at a Disdainful Stroke. Yeah. Alright. Done. Bam! Hand's broken. The old turn 1, nothing go, huh? I was expecting a little bit more out of you, won't I? Go. You're probably just looking to play a long game with Veil of Summer for us. Whoa, Tranquil Thicket? You're deep, homie. You are deep in the weeds. Deep in the weeds. They're probably considering going for it here, which would be, I feel like, pretty moronic if I lit on Field of Ruin. Obviously, I'm mulligan the Force. Oh my god, don't go for it. Wild Canter? That is fine. Alright, yeah, they're gonna have what's it called? Force Negation up. I mean, Veil of the Bullshit. The card that makes sense. Alright, we're dead. That sucks. I feel like if we drew a land, we were very in this game. But it'd be like that sometimes. They should have beat me down with this Cantor. Do you really not have it? Are you kidding me with this? Maybe they're just like, wait, oh my god, they really don't have it. Alright, fine. Do I have 8 cards yet? No, go. Look, it's like we never mulliganed. This is all part of my calculated plan, chat. Alright, drawing the Veil of Summer, I guess. You know I'm going to draw a land eventually. You should probably actually try to kill me. Oh my god. Ah! I'm going to discard Supreme Verdict to make a statement. Look, this card is in my deck and it is busted. What are you doing? Dude, I do not care. Thanks for sharing. Goodbye. This has been good magic. New brand. I really like what it does to the format. This is just good magic. Good fun magic we're playing here. That is fine. That's an Allosaurus Rider. They're just going to attack with it. Bet. They're not going to do it. Oh my god. They're actually going for it. Are you kidding me? What are you doing? Why would you go for this? Whatever. Pitch Cryptic Command. Oh no. Well, now we have to win on their turn. Is there anything we can surgical that makes sense? We can surgical Allosaurus Riders, but I think we want them to draw those. Oh no. Hmm. So they have to win this turn. They have no mana. Very likely to So, Surgicaling also Shredder doesn't do a ton, but we're just going to let it happen. Alright, well, you've packed it. Win. Summoner's packed. This is probably just going to go grab that stupid animal thing, right? The stupid worm. Alright, fine. Yeah. Yep. Okay. Alright. Let this one happen. In response to the next one, I think we're going to try a Surgical Nourishing Show. We're going to hope they don't draw one off the first one. And we're going to try a Surgical Nourishing Show. Packed. Shoal. Yeah, Surgical Nourishing Shoal. Gotcha. They can just go off on top of it, but that's fine. Hopefully it makes their Nourishing Shoals worse. This does increase, I think, their likelihood of fizzling. What the crap? Okay. Fine. You've cast all the packs. I'm done. I have no more free spells. I'm dead. Just freaking packed all the times. You've packed it. It's all packed it. You did it. You've packed it every single time. There's so many packs. Alright, pretty sure you hit the Nourishing Shell. Congratulations, you win the game. Show me that you still have the win condition. Labman's gonna be the bottom card. Yep. Draw, we lose. Alright, that was pretty fun magic. Had a good time. Wow. I don't even want Mentor in my deck. I really kind of don't. But I don't really want Path in my deck either. Whatever, let's just click submit. They're planning on fighting me with packs, not with veils, so I guess that'll make sense. They're kind of down to grind a little bit, so we actually do need to have a win condition. Perfect. Keep. I say perfect now, and like we're just not gonna be able. We're gonna be playing a turn two ambush viper, just like hoping to get there. Is this Disdainful Stroke a blank card against them? No, it counters Outsource Riders. Moon Rabbit. By the way, you know me, Drake. Where do I know you from, Moon Rabbit? Alright. Mold the 6. Show Chancellor the Tangle. That's fine. I don't care about any of this. Don't care! Oh, you're right. I try to be. Work. Oh, is that you, Josh? How's it going? Playing some magics. Probably gonna die. This is actually pretty horrible gameplay for you to walk in on, because like none of it's gonna make sense and it's gonna happen really quickly because this deck is degenerate and the deck I'm playing sucks. You leaking my name? Oh, scum. I don't think anybody in chat knows who you are or even knows where I work. They can probably figure it out if they tried hard enough. Just don't be a degenerate on the internet. You'll be fine. Oh no, do they have the pack too? Oh, gross. I mean, if they have Pact 2, what can you do, right? Like, we know one of their cards. Whatever. Please don't have it. Okay. Sweet gameplay. We made one game action. God, that was miserable. Our broken deck continues to be broken. We're 4-0, going for a 5-0. You'll love to see it, chat. You'll love to see it. Goes on Facebook. Yeah, sure. You still couldn't even find it. Like, you still would have to, like, somehow get the building because they work adjacent to me. Ugh. I appreciate you stopping by, though. It does mean a lot. We're doing well tonight, too. We haven't lost a match yet with our busted deck. This for the memes, since you don't play Magic. This deck is not the best deck in the format. I've had somebody subscribe, and you know, with their subscription I offer you know, I'll play whatever deck they want me to within reason. And this is an established deck in the format that, like, always sees play, but is never really, like, the best deck. And that's because it's a more reactive deck. You're trying to control what they're doing instead of, like, I don't know, proactively run them down with kill creatures. You're not trying to, like, actively kill them. You're just trying to stop them from doing anything and grind them out of resources as the game goes along. So, like, that strategy is inherently worse than strategies that are just trying to kill your opponent pretty quickly. And so I often meme about how this deck is unplayable, and now, of course, we're 4-0 with it, and we're playing for a 5-0. So it's just like, I don't know. It's what can you do? This is just how this deck goes. Sometimes you draw your Force of Negations, and they concede. I see. Take notes. Yeah, this is not ideal gameplay for you to be watching as your introduction to Magic. There's plenty of other Magic streams, but, you know, I appreciate you stopping, hanging out, spending some time with me. Our broken deck won on turn one. That's true. We did win on their turn one. That is so busted. They just had no interest in continuing to play. Yeah, we didn't actually kill them last game, for the record. We were very far from actually killing them by putting their life to zero, but they just didn't want to keep playing because they were pretty sure they were dead. Do we just keep functional mana plus, like, stuff? Is this something I can keep in the format? I don't think it is. I feel like we probably at least need a pass, like a path. Hey, Sandwich Sultan, thank you much for the follow. I really appreciate it. Like, this feels like a hand. This is what I'm talking about when I say Blood Control looks like it always has the worst possible opening hands. It's like, none of this looks playable in the format. My first play's on turn three, but, like, I bet we're supposed to keep this. What do you think, chat? What do you think? Keep or mole? Keeps or moles? This is great trust. Oh, God. I don't know if I'm on trust. I don't know if I'm on trust. Oh, man. Chat has nothing to say. I'm leaning towards mulliganing this, but I feel like this is like, I don't know if we have the luxury of mulliganing this. I don't know if our deck provides better hands than this. I've had one too many Field of Ruin only hands tonight. Keep 110%. I think this one is mediocre. So I have a keep, and a mediocre. Alright. That doesn't really help me a ton. Playable. Alright, looks like the chat's towards keeping. I think we're supposed to mulligan this. Do we really have to keep this? My gosh. Gabe Nassif seizes and he snaps it off. Well, I'm not Gabriel Nassif. I can't just be better than all my opponents. Alright, we got enough playables. We'll keep it. I've been swayed, chat. I've been swayed. Oh, gosh. Is this like Storm again? It's another Steam Vince deck. It's like Storm. Could be Phoenix. This hand's actually pretty good against Phoenix. Because, like, whatever they do on turn two, we can just catch with our Detention Sphere. And then we have, like, Cryptic Command as, like, a follow-up. As long as it's not... Oh, they put two cards on top. As long as they don't have, like, Quick Birds, I think we're in okay shape. We're going to concern Blight here by leading on Hallowed Fountain. Because these fetch lands are probably going to fetch basics. Since we have one Hallowed Fountain, usually they really need one dual land. And, like, these two Flooded Strands are pretty locked to fetch islands. We need them to, like, play a turn two thing, like, not flip it on turn three. Or just, like, not, like, cantrip here and, like, play, like, an Aria next turn. Not a Storm creature. Alright. This looks like Birds. Quick Birds is fine. We can take our 14 and, like, Detention Sphere. Even just one Bird I'm super okay with, because then, like, we're drawing to Path as, like, a pretty good out. Okay, what's happening right here is I think they have the looting but don't have the Birds and are debating not casting their looting. No, see, I think you cast your looting. If you're committed, you're committed. I think they should have cast the looting there. Because you're giving up on the value of having played free spells. Like, you cash in your free spell. That's one of the most, like, powerful things your deck does. This right here is, I think, a teaching moment for Is It Phoenix. I think you're supposed to jam it. Now, I'm kind of a spewer. I understand I tend to spew my spells. But, like, I think you're supposed to jam the Faithless Looting there, even if you don't have the Birds yet. Because the upside of drawing the Bird is so high. And, like, you probably have some cards you don't mind discarding anyway. They might have an Aria they're trying to save it for. That's what the Snap Fetch kind of signals to me, that they have an Aria Flame. But I think you're supposed to jam the looting there most of the time if you're going for it. What the hell? All right. Main deck, Blood Moon. Is this, like, Blue Moon? I don't understand. Island? I don't even know if I'm supposed to Detention Sphere this.
Like, it might actually lock down their mana more than mine. I kind of wish I'd fetched another island, but it'd be like that. If I draw an island, I'm... Fine. We'll cast it. If I drew another island, I was not actually. Like, I don't care that much about the Cryptic. It could shut off a Cryptic. Like, the rest of my hand would have been castable. You cast looting there? I agree, Brock. Use the Detention Sphere's ability. Please. You always loot 100%? Yeah, I agree. This looks like another Morphos. Yeah. I wonder if they found a bird by now. They might have. White? What? You made red white? What is happening, chat? What the fuck? I'm so confused. I have much confusion. I'm tempted to just click them. I think I'm going to hold up Cryptic and click them on end step if they don't do anything. Whereas, like, catching an Aria with Cryptic seems so high upside. It's a Phoenix. We could, okay, so we could do something kind of cute here. We could fetch an island and, like, Cryptic Command, bounce Detention Sphere, counter Arclight Phoenix. Because it locks down their mana, puts them on only one blue, they've spewed two Morphoses. I'm kind of here for it. I don't know. Is that insane, chat? Is that insane? Why does that feel kind of insane? Because now that I can fetch my second island, I don't care about this Blood Moon at all. I actually think I'm going to do it. Like, it might lock me out of future Cryptic Commands, but it doesn't lock me out of anything else. All right. Oh, it locks me out of Supreme Verdict. I'm okay with that? I think so. Counter target spell, return target permanent to its own hand. Target spell, return Detention Sphere. Because Detention Sphere is a high quality card in this matchup. And I really hated wasting it on the Blood Moon. Whereas this I like a lot. Alright. Punish me. Oh, we drew another island? I'm a freaking master. God, we can almost snap Cryptic under this. Alright, so let's stop them on their draw step and we're going to click them. We're going to scope out the goods, see what's going on. Draw, boop, burp, blurp. And this is looking for, like, Morphoses. We just want to keep them from bringing back their Arclight Phoenix, basically. This gives them a target for their Lightning Bolts, which they have. Sinkhole, Bolt, Surgical. So yeah, here we go. We're going to take an Arclight, and they're going to have to, like, spew to bring back this Phoenix, and then we're just going to, like, exile it. Do we even take anything, then? Because they're going to bolt this. Like, they're planning to just, like, kill a bunch of my stuff, but none of their cards actually really do anything. If they just play Arclight Phoenix... No, I'll take the Arclight. I think taking the Arclight's good enough. If something happens to our Detention Sphere... Like, if they just spew spells to, like, bolt my click and then, like, bolt me twice or whatever to bring back Arclight, then, like, we're super okay with that. I guess they didn't have a looting all along. That's wild to me. They drew a blue cantrip? Nice. Mill me? Sure. Surgical Path to Exile? Okay. That's unfortunate, but I don't think I particularly care. Bolt this. Yep, and then bolt me. You drew an island? So lucky. Yeah. This one's on the sideboard guide. It's so true. I feel like, I can't help but feel like we're really favored to win this game as it goes on. Even though, like, a lot of our spells aren't really, like, doing a lot. I really feel like we're like pretty likely to win this game. Yeah, bolt it. So now they have, they've been through bolt, bolt, surgical. So they have magmatic sinkhole bolt, and they have no target for sinkhole at the moment. So we're not going to run out the Snapcaster and give them targets for it. Oh, that's so unfortunate. Because it means they get to just sinkhole it on their turn. Although if we draw a counter spell, we're in like pretty good shape to protect it. Minus two. Let's look for a Cryptic Command. They could just bolt it as well. Oh, Teferi's a good one. Teferi's a very good one. Pick up my Detention Sphere. You don't hate to see it, Jet. You don't hate to see it. The Cryptic Command's pretty attractive as well. But the fact we can cast Teferi this turn, I think, locks it in for what we want to be doing. I can bolt Narset. Pretty cool with that. You can minus to pick up Detention Sphere. And then if they bring back their bird... Oh, Jace is so nice. Now we have Detention Sphere. We can, like, Detention Sphere Blood Moon. Oh, no. 4 mana. They drew an Arclight Phoenix? Very lucky. They just kill Narset, I guess. Yeah, that makes a lot of sense. So we can play a land. If we Detention Sphere, how much mana do we have? We have 5, so we're still short. Being able to Detention Sphere both birds. We can Detention Sphere Blood Moon again, and that unlocks Verdict. We can plus up and then like protect our Teferi. Plus this up. Alternatively, we could just like Jace Brainstorm. We still know they have Bolts, Magmatic Sinkhole. I think at the point we have Snap Cryptic available to us. It just like doesn't really make any sense to keep playing this game. Alright, fine. Detention Sphere. We'll Detention Sphere the Blood Moon again. We're just so far ahead on resources now that I think it only really makes sense. There you go. Now, like I said, if they like spew a bunch of resources bringing back birds, we're just going to be okay with it. Do we protect this? 1, 2, 3, 4. Think we do. Because I want to keep it around. Yeah, we'll just Verdict. Like, they can still bolt it, but that's fine. I want them to use resources on that, not, like, Jace and stuff. Clicking the minus button on Narset. They had Magmatic Sinkhole. That we knew about. Alright. Yeah, I think I'm going to tap like this. So we can play a Jace. Oh, we should. Gosh, they have Bolt. Whatever, let's just Brainstorm. If they're bolting now, I'm pretty cool with that. Wow! How about 3 ops? Okay. I don't really think this accomplishes a lot. Get rid of an opt. A fetch land. Play Colonnade tapped. Actually, let's plus this up first. Play Colonnade tapped. Pass. And then we're gonna Field of Ruin before we sleight of hand. Alright, that's fine.
We're gonna filter in before we do any drawing. It sucks that our paths have gotten rid of. I think we're gonna have to bounce this detention sphere again. Thing in the ice. That's fine. Bolts, Jace. Pull that up. They're gonna like bolt plus sinkhole or whatever and like hit me for a bunch. Although they're spewing a lot of resources, so I might just snap verdict actually. We'll see. Island. I actually think I'm just gonna let this happen. Cause like they have to use all their things to get back Phoenixes. And like I said, I'm totally down on them like using their resources because I really want to snap verdict. Deal it one time. Three of a kind dealer, what do I win? What's up, Tannen? Yeah, once again, okay with this. Would die to a Phoenix attack anyway, so not really looking to spend cards on that. I'm going to hit for 6, down to 9. Wish we could find one of our surgicals. That's probably what we're going to go looking for with these ops. So we can snap verdict on the surgical, and then we're just in very, very good shape. Opt. Force of negation. Not really good enough anymore. Oh, no. Opt. Cryptic command. I do think that one is good enough. Yeah, I think that one's good enough. Okay. Big Teferi, eh? Big Teferi's a good one. Big Teferi's a very good one. Now we need to decide what matters. Snap verdict costs 6 mana. Gosh, we're gonna run out of time. So I think we just play Teferi plus. We even still snapping verdict? I don't think we are. I think we're gonna cryptic tap team bounce detention sphere. We're gonna try to detention sphere these. Well, we could just tap, we just counter draw. I don't know. I kinda wanna bounce the detention sphere again, try to catch these birds again. We know there's one on the bottom of their deck. Yeah, we'll play it to Teferi. And plus it. Mana leak. Maybe we'll just like time walk them a bunch with cryptics and then end it with a snap verdict. That actually seems a little bit better. So I'm actually gonna play this land out. I actually think I'm just gonna time walk them a bunch. Boop. Yeah, our plan is to time walk a bunch, win the game with this Teferi. And just, like, eventually verdict all their stuff, and then we'll exile Phoenixes with, like, my triggers and stuff. They're really low on bolts. They have, like, one left, and we get to hold up Cryptic the whole time for Arya. Beginning of combat. Tap all creatures opponents control. Draw a card. Yep, love to see it. Okay. Faithless Looting. Sure. It's a pretty good one to draw, actually. Another spell lets them flip, and then they can just like put the phoenixes back in the yard. Protects them. They can like just flashback. They're probably going to want to wait to flashback till next turn, but it makes a lot of sense for them to flashback. Just waiting to play Overwatch. Why didn't you plus 2 on Jace? Because they had Magmatic Sinkhole, and so like it didn't matter. Like as long as the loyalty was less than 5, it didn't matter what the loyalty of my Planeswalkers was. They have another sinkhole? That would be disastrous for my plan. Set Adrift. I think I'm okay with that, actually. So we're ahead on cards. I guess we should opt here. Because I wanna see, like, the next card I would draw. All right, I bought that. Surgical.
Okay. Alright. So, three mana for Teferi, technically. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Yeah, we can snap Cryptic still. Okay. Here's a Teferi. Plus draw card. Prismatic Vista. Might hold that. I think I'm going to hold that. Yeah. We're going to hold that. Hold that thought. Just untap two blue sources. Go. So they'll play a bird, we'll mana leak it and surgical. Actually, we can just Cryptic tap draw. Or no, we can Cryptic counter that bounce Awoken Horror. That's pretty nice, actually. Hopefully they don't have surgical. That'd be frustrating. Cryptic Command. I mean, we're not dead if they have surgical, but... Alright. Counter a thing, return a permanent. Counter that, bounce that. Blue, blue, blue. Blue. Blurp. I think I'm supposed to wait and untap before surgicaling. Let's plus Teferi. That's a lot of lands. Alright, let's surgical. Go to 7. Bird, bird. What's in your hand? The last bolt. So we can't take any damage or we're in trouble. We get all 4 birds. Alright, I think we're locked to win this game now, but we need to actually, like, hurry up and win it. Alright. I didn't see how many basics they have. God, I'm an idiot. Whatever. Animate Colonnade. Can I animate the second Colonnade? I'm a land short. Should have played my land last turn. Forehead. Whatever. They're dead next turn. Alright. Yeah, there's nothing else we can really do. Untap 2 lands. Go! This keeps them from bolting. We still just animate 2 colonnades. We win the game, so I think I'm supposed to just spew the mana leak. Mana leak. Which, like, keeps them from doing any kind of funny business this turn. Not really sure what they could have, but if they draw a second sinkhole, because I didn't look at that either, then we're in trouble. Alright, that's fine. Yeah, joke's on you, I already have the land, animate the second colonnade! So we can minus 3 to move the thing in the ice out of the way, and they can't fetch either, so yeah, we'll just minus 3. Play land. Animate a colonnade. I guess we should make the mana first so I don't screw this up. Yay, we won! It only took an hour. We have 10 minutes to win the future games. This is fine. This matchup is just as grindy in paper as this, actually, for the record. Like, playing this matchup in paper is pretty miserable. So we're gonna have to hope to win really quickly. And this matchup's on the trusty sideboard guide, so let's get that going. Forehead, he says, as he gets so close to the screen, that's all we see. Yeah, exactly. That's what I'm demonstrating to you. Once the cards get really tiny, I can't see them anymore because my vision sucks. And so I have to, like, get really close to the screen. It's a disaster. All right. Phoenix. Blue-red Phoenix. There we go. We want Purges, Rest in Peace, Baneslayer Angel, Bring Him or Rip if you see Ascension or Finale. Out, one Snapcaster. Mathematical. Oust. Supreme Verdict, timely. I buy all that. All this card's gonna suck. Alright. Oust, timely. We want The Purges. The one rip. A Veto. And an Angel. Kind of want to bring in Mentors. I'm not kidding. Because, like, I think they're supposed to shave on Bolt. And we're low on time. I realize it's bad against Thing in the Ice. I understand that. I actually think I want another rip. Which is because I think it's important in the matchup. I didn't cut a Snapcaster. Actually, I want to cut another Snapcaster. The Planeswalkers are, like, fine. Force of Negation is, like, fine. Spell Snare is good. Surgical is, like, fine. I guess Surgical is, like, a little bit better. Ugh. I really want these Mentors in the deck. Logic Mod seems slow. Come board this out. Is that insane? Why does it feel insane? I'm boarding this out. This card's depressing. Vendilion Clique attacks, so we're going to leave it in the deck. Yeah, that's a good reason to keep Snapcaster in the deck. Oh, Oust is still in my deck for some reason. Alright. I think I'm going to try something like this. Solely, like I said, I'm only bringing in Mentors because I think they're going to cut Bolts, and we need to win. We have 10 minutes. So we're going to have to win this game a little bit faster. Cut Nod if you have two rips. Yeah, see, that's so reasonable. I'm so smart. Yeah, it looks like it was marked for if you brought in more rips. I mean, maybe. You know me. I like me some rips and Snapcasters. That's good deck building. When I have rips and Snapcasters on my deck, that's how you know I have a well-built deck in front of me. I think Mentor is real bad, but that's just me. I mean, it's not great. Because they do need to leave in some bolts to pressure the walkers, but their bolts, I think, are already a little taxed because they have to, like, pressure the walkers. Rips an Ambush Viper. Ambush Viper gets the job done, all right? When you have 10 minutes on the clock, you don't have time to dawdle. You got to Ambush Viper him. All right. Golly. I think this is a keep, but this hand is depressing. Keep. We're, like, dead to a Thing in the Ice, just, like, at any point in time. But this hand beats basically everything else. I'm going to Force of Negation a Faithless Looting on turn two. As long as it's the third spell, right? Like, if they're going to go, like, Morphos or whatever. Well, that's a good draw. You don't hate to see that. That's not something you hate to see, Jet. That's not something you hate to see at all. They're passing. We're going to win! Hopefully! Does this mean I just aggressively mana leak the cantrip they're about to cast? Oh, they don't even have a cantrip. We're so good at this game. They drew a Spire Bluff Canal. What masters? What professional magic players they are. Faithless Looting. I'm not Force Negationing that. Am I? Oh my gosh. They're missing lands. We can click them next turn. Oh, this is so aggressive. This is so aggressive. I wear your granddad's clothes. I'm going to gain leak this Faithless Looting. Rot with Snare Thopters in your hand. I say rot. All right, we have Force Negation, so I'm actually going to do this click on draw step, only because I feel safe because of the Force Negation. Click you. Click you. Bolt it. Ding. Yeah, that's fine. We're going to let that happen. Arclight Phoenix, Blood Moon, Magmatic Sinkhole. Well, we're going to take Saheeli. All right, let's get a snip of this. I feel very smart, thin, and handsome for countering that Faithless Looting. I'll tell you what. All right, take the Saheeli. All right. That was on their draw step, so they're doing stuff. They didn't draw land because we're professionals. All right, we have a Colonnade now. So, let's play the Colonnade. Oh, this isn't let a snap leak, but I think I'm okay with that because I really want to fire off this Field of Ruin anyway. White. Put a stop on opponent's turn. That happens. Purge it. cards. We've traded one for one. Here's a Celestial Colonnade. Pass the turn. We're at 8 minutes left to win this game. The flashback Faith is looting. We're going to... Oh my god. F off with this. I might just snap Leak just because I want to get a clock going. What's their hand? They have a Magmatic Sinkhole. So we know they don't have Blood Moon anymore. They don't have Saheeli. They have Arclight Phoenix, Magmatic Sinkhole. If they drew a land, I feel like such an idiot. I really don't want to snap Leak. But I'm going to, I think. Snapcaster Mage. Target Mana Leak. Gotta get him dead. Leak that. Alright. Path to Exile. That's a good draw. I kind of want to shoot their Islet right now. Is that insane? If I do, what does that leave me with? 1, 2, 3. It'll leave me with plenty of mana. Let's attack first. I'm going to shoot their Islet. They can either crack it, because they really don't want to crack it. Yeah, they're just letting it happen. That makes a lot of sense. Alright, let's grab an island. And we still get to leave up Cryptic. Alright, I think they're incentivized to just, like, flashback looting every turn. So, we're hopefully going to be able to just, like, run them out of stuff. They might just snare Thopter here. In which case, we will path that. Yeah. Combat, Otark. Path it. And this should be their third basic. Once again, didn't look to see how many basics they have, so I don't know if Field of Ruining here is correct or not, but I'm probably going to do it. Although they can sinkhole me. I don't want them to sinkhole me. Whatever, I'm just gonna do it. Blow up this. We have the extra mana to do it, so we'll do it on their second main. Well, this lets them play. This lets them play Serum Visions if they have it. They have a second mountain? That's insanity. Surgical Faithless Looting? Yeah. Blurp derp. They have two Arclight Phoenixes in their hand. That's fine. Alright. Got all four, right? 1, 2, 3, 4. Excellent. So I do have a plan to win this game. We're going to counter the next Snare Thopter, bounce Snapcaster Mage, and then we're going to Snapcast Surgical. Although they have Bolt in their hand that we know about, right? Can I target spell? Return this to my hand. I guess letting them bolt it is fine. Because they can't sinkhole it. They should bolt this in response. But we're gonna pressure them with Colonnade because we only have 6 minutes left to win this game. So we're just looking to win the race so the next bird doesn't actually do anything. Oh my god. Opponent, please. What the heck? What the heck was that? Oh, they're like Hail Marying for a... What are they doing? Alright, whatever. I don't know what they're doing. We're just going to Snapcast Surgical Extraction on their birds and hope they don't have a Surgical. Ah! Playing within time constraints! Pay 2 life.
They have a bird and a sinkhole. Alright, so they can sinkhole my first colonnade, but they can't get the second one. I don't know when I'm gonna need this, and this is probably just wasting time, but I wanna see the library. Do they have another basic? Oh god. Looks like they do not. Excellent. Okay. Hey, thank you very much for the follow, Bick Noten? Hopefully I said that right. Bick Noten, thank you much for the follow, I really appreciate it. Oh gosh. Animate. Combat. Attack. If they kill my colony, we're actually gonna path it. That way we can cast this, that way we can animate the second colony. I'm just not kidding at all. Which is kind of tragic. Because we have colonnades for days. Alright. White. Path. It. Yes. Grab another island. Yeah, sure. Alright. Hit you for two. Put you to eight. You have no cards in hand. No faithless lootings. We just need them to not draw insanely well. And we can win in 5 minutes very easily. They just conceded. Go! Look at that. Look at that, chat. Look at all this riches. We're so rich. Look at all this stuff. We're so lucky. So busted. They just conceded. Oh, you love to see it. You love to see it. Oh, yeah. Deck's so... It's so good. It's so good. Look at that. Look at all those wins. We played against top-tier deck Storm twice. The old Neo Brands. The old, what was the other, I don't even know what the other one was. It was like Storm, oh, Death Shadow, Jun Shadow, and we beat 2-0, is it Phoenix? Busted decks, busted, best deck in the format, I solved it. How have you like blue-white? Ryan, it is broken. We beat Storm, let me tell you what, we beat Storm, we beat Neobrand, Shadow, like, come on. Deck's so good. Yeah, we didn't play against Hogak at all, we didn't play against Drawn at all, and these matchups both seem god-awful. I mean, Blue White's always like a fine deck. You're just kind of rolling the matchup lottery. Let's have a look at the deck list. So this list is pretty close to what I'd want to play. I think I'd want to play another Vendilion Clique. Teferi's actually looked kind of fine. Picking up our Detention Sphere kind of mattered. Picking up our own Snapcaster Mages was very viable. I really like the four Snapcaster Mages here. I still kind of wish this was an On Thin Ice, but we never drew it, so I don't really care that much. The Spell Snare was surprisingly relevant. I wasn't really anticipating that. I do want some more Force of Negations in this 75. Not having a third one in the 75 really, really felt tragic. Because there's multiple matchups I think I want them. And not having access to it was really frustrating. And like not being able to feel like I could comfortably mulligan to it was also very frustrating. Not really sure how much we need three Cryptic Commands, but they look good. We can always line them up. I didn't really draw Jace as much as I wanted to. There was a couple times when we were top decking that I was like, ah, please something. And we had to kind of puck them out with Colonnade. Colonnade looked great. I was happy to play three. I mean, hell, I was happy just to not have a damn Field of Ruin as my opening hand land. It was so bad. I think we had at least three hands. Whereas the only card, like, the only land in our opening hand, which feels so unlikely. But, man, do you feel it when you have it. The Prismatic Vista felt calculated. I don't know. The mana base probably needs help. The main deck spells are pretty close to solved. Like, I kind of want to find room for another click in the 75, and I kind of want to find room for another Force of Negation in the 75. And maybe that just goes in, like, the Mentor slots? I don't really know. But Teferi did seem fine. It was good enough. And it impacted the board, which mattered. So I wasn't unhappy with it like I thought I was going to be. Overall, I felt pretty prepared for most matchups. Yeah, this list felt pretty reasonable. I really appreciate Shadows. Thank you, Shadows in the chat. You know, they're a subscriber. You subscribe to me. You get one sub list each month that you are a subscriber. You submit them in the Discord, which the link should be popping up every now and again in chat. You can click on that. Get out of the Discord. If you're a sub, you can post to your list in the subscriber's Discord. I mean, or in the, I'm sorry, the subscriber sub list submission channel. And you know, I'll play that as soon as I get the next opportunity to. I do only stream once a week, so you're going to have to bear with me. But I was really happy to play his deck. It was a lot of fun. Really appreciate your support, Shadows. We're actually going to play another sub list here in a second. But before we go, I think I want to finish talking about blue-white control. I'm excited for a time where we don't have to play four Rest in Peace in our sideboard. These, once again, feel pretty awful, along with, because they shut off our Surgical Extractions, they shut off our Snapcaster Mages. Like, our deck just does not look like a Rest in Peace deck at all, especially not a four Rest in Peace deck, but, because, like, I have to leave Snapcasters in. I don't think you can be in a spot in Modern where you're just like, I'm gonna board all my Snapcasters out, because they're, one of the ways you win the game with any, like, any speed at all. And they're also one of the games, like, they're also one of your best cards if you don't have Rest in Peace. And so, like, the upside of having them when you don't have Rip is, like, worth the downside of only having Ambush Viper when you do have Rest in Peace, I think. So, pretty happy with that. Purge felt great. The counter spells felt fine. Not really sure those are the correct counter spells to have, but we never played the mirror. And as always, it feels like we have maybe too many cards for the mirror. I don't know if we... Whatever. This felt fine. There's only some minor changes I would make. I wouldn't make major overhauls to this deck list. Big fan of Supreme Verdict pitching to Force of Negation. That's something I liked in Legacy a lot, and I'm really happy it carries over to Force of Negation here in Modern. All right. Do we have any questions before we move on to playing some Snow Shift? Bring to light Snow Shift. What do you think? You can play against one actual deck. Hey, look, bite me, all right? Bite me. To get people dead. Yeah, I hit play against four field. I trimmed down to three. The thing is, if you trim down to three, I feel like you can't beat Tron. I feel like you legitimately cannot beat Tron if you trim down to three. Yeah. Either way, there are no further questions. I'm going to go ahead and wrap up this particular iteration. Do you think Blue-Eyed is a better choice than Phoenix right now? Jeez. That's close. I think it's close. I think Phoenix probably ekes it out. Like, I think Blue-Red Phoenix is a little bit better of a choice. That may be just my own personal bias speaking, but I think it's very close. Like, I think you could make a good argument for Blue-White being better positioned. Because, like, all the Tron all over the place, I legitimately think that Blue-White has a better chance to get Tron by a lot than Phoenix does. And Hogak, like, I think your matchup's pretty close to the same. I think that Mono-Red Phoenix is pretty close to the same for both decks. And so, like, really Tron and Eldrazi Tron are the big ones, and I think that Blue-White probably kind of dunks on those. I actually might play Blue-White in Richmond. I'm not really considering it, but I kind of am. I don't know. After today, I'm willing to look at it more. I'm willing to take another look at Blue-White control for Richmond after this kind of, like, I don't know. It felt powerful. Force of Negation is a hell of a magic card, y'all. I'm going to play more Force of Negations, but the card's so good. The card is so good. How'd you like the one of Vista? It was actually kind of bad. I won't lie. Like, the one time I drew it, I, like, wanted to fetch a Hallowed Fountain because it was the only colored source because I had a freaking Field of Ruin, and it was kind of embarrassing. So, if I had On Thin Ice, I think I would like it a lot more. And, like, I've talked about that multiple times. Like, it's just, like, a better one-mana removal spell. But, either way, Blue-White has a much better Mono-Red matchup. It also has a much better Burn matchup if that's a deck people are playing. But I don't really think that deck's that good either. So, anyway, thank you very much. I know we have a lot of viewers in here right now. I really appreciate all of your support. If you're watching here on Twitch and you like my content, hit that follow button. It's the easiest way to support me on Twitch, and we'll let you know when I go live. It doesn't cost you a dime. If you're watching on YouTube, really appreciate your support. Hey, got a brand. Thank you much for the follow. Look, see, just got to remind him. If you're watching on YouTube and you've enjoyed my content, please hit that subscribe button. It doesn't cost you a dime. Let you know when I post more videos. Another way to support me, my stream, and Team Nova is to support my sponsors. They are still scattered all over my stream, as I still have not gotten an updated video beneath my head for the other two sponsors that are on the other side of the screen. So we'll just run through the sponsors real quick. Check out Mage. They are a brand that now has multiple apps for Magic the Gathering available in the App Store. Although one of them is not fully released yet, they're releasing a StockX-style market for you guys to buy and sell cards safely on. Looks really exciting. There's a lot of people that have already done their interviews for that, and they are pretty excited about it. They also have basically the best Magic the Gathering app on the market. I don't want to say the best because I haven't checked them all out, but on iOS I haven't found a better app yet. Really enjoy the Mage app, and it doesn't cost you a dime to download it, so you should check them out. They're pretty great, and we appreciate their support. Also, check out Introspective. You can use code TeamNovaMTG on their site for 10% off their clothes. They are a clothing brand that supports Team Nova and some of the other teams on the SCG Tour. So you should check out their clothes. I actually was wearing one of their shirts on my last stream. So if you want to see that, you can see one of their shirts from my last YouTube videos where I was playing some Standard. But their clothing's great. It's high quality stuff. Really happy to use it. They also make our jerseys that we wear. And so really, really appreciate the support. Really like their content. You can find a link to them in the panels below or in the description below if you're watching on YouTube. And you can check out the sponsors that have been rolling beneath my head here. Start off, we got ManaChairs.com is the rental service that I use to play all these sublists and other wacky decks for you guys. So really appreciate their service. Used their service for a long time. I mean, I'm going on like 2.5 years now, and I can't say enough positive things about them. Their support's easy to work with. Their service makes a lot of sense. It's very intuitive and works well. And so their service is great if you're looking to get better at Magic, looking to play some more decks on Moto without, you know, hemorrhaging money. And you can pay for it using ticks. That was one of the best developments. Is if you're went in a lot on Magic Online, you could just pay for it using the ticks, and they actually give you a bonus for adding those ticks to your wallet. So highly recommend checking them out. Use code TNOVAMTG for 15% off your first 3 months with them. Get started using the link below. Also got Inklin Customs. This has done all the artwork for Team Nova, including our logo, tokens, and playmats. She follows around a lot of the big tournaments, including Mythic Championships, some Magic Fests, and some SCG Opens. So you can check out her stuff. She got reasonable prices on her website for all of her tokens and her other artwork. If you're looking to get a custom token made, there's a reason she called Inklin Customs. Her work looks fantastic. And you can check her out on Twitter to see some of that work. So if you're at a big event and she's there, please go check out her booth. She's awesome. If not, you're looking to get tokens from her, just order online, use the link below, and we appreciate her support. We got the In Games, which is a store in Charlottesville local to some of our players. They let us rent cards and buy cards at a discount. You can too, using code TNOVAMTG for 10% off. Link to their storefront is below. They're an excellent, excellent local game store. Always happy to support your local game stores, especially ones that support us, and we really appreciate their sponsorship. And last but not least, we got hipstersofthecoast.com, which is a content production website that all of Team Nova writes for. We have a weekly, article that comes out that's our What We Play. It has our deck lists in it for each tournament that we're going to be playing. It has each member post the deck list they're going to be playing there, and you know, a little bit on why. Also have individual articles coming out each week. Mine should be up later this week. I've been a little late on my article because I really want to make sure I get this one right. But they have plenty of other content available for you if you're looking to get a little better at Magic. They also have other merchandise, podcasts, articles, all kinds of stuff. And their website's very easy to navigate. Really appreciate their support. All right. Thank you all, and I'll check you next time.